This is definitely a staple in any Croatian house.
Croatian checkers.
So you have to have the right size pot in order for the coffee, I guess, to taste how it should. Hi everybody and welcome back to our channel. Today we're gonna do another kind of Croatian culture vlog. I'm gonna walk you through about 15 things that every traditional Croatian household probably has. What better place to do that than at Ivan's parents' house? They're both pretty traditional Croats, so I'm sure I'm gonna find everything on the list right here. Okay, so first things first, there have to be many different pairs of slippers, some for people who live here and some for guests, of course. There are two different kinds, one with a hard sole at the bottom, like the rubber sole, and the second kind is like this really knitted soft pair, and sometimes people even wear those soft knitted kind inside the ones with a rubber sole, just for extra protection from the cold through the winter months.
To je ručni rad, koja je moja mama plela, kada udobno I toplo.
Evo. Zašto moramo nositi papuče?
Tak da se ne prehladimo, da noge ono, da je toplo za noge.
They even make me wear slippers when I come over here. They chase me around if I'm not wearing them, make sure I have them on my feet. The next thing everyone has in their house if they are Croatian is a bottle of rakija. It can be homemade, it can be from the store, but everyone has to have rakija. There are so many uses for it. Ivan's gonna tell you just a few of them.
We celebrate with rakija, we drink rakija, you know, like when you invite friends, when you have a maestro or a handyman, you know, fixing something, maestro, do you want a rakija, you know, or you offer him rakija, you have to offer people with rakija, you know. If you don't have rakija, it's kind of weird. When I was a kid, I remember my parents were putting on my forehead or my arms when I had a fever. It's like magical medical use. Then also, if you cut yourself, then you put rakija on your wound, you know, like cleanse your wound. Yeah, that's the rakija. Has amazing multiple use and it's great Croatian product.
Usually it's typical to have that kind of clear rakija, but then this is also common to have, and this is more for like women to have a sweeter rakija when they come to someone's house to like give them a little drink to welcome them to your home. So usually women will drink the sweeter kind and the men will drink the harder flavors that are a little bit stronger. But of course that's no hard set rule, it's just typically what I've noticed here. So here's a cross hanging behind me. It's very typical to have at least one cross hanging in your house. About 90% of Croatians are Catholic, so you'll definitely find one or two or even more hanging in a traditional Croatian house. Here up on the door, a lot of Croatians will have these stickers, and that is from when the priest comes over and they bless the house, and so they give you this sticker.
Se blagosiva.
Godišnje
jednom se I dobijemo te naljepnice. To su kao zaštitnici obitelji.
The priest was actually just here this morning blessing the house for 2021, so Dita is just putting up the sticker now. Vegeta is a staple in any Croatian household, traditional or not. Kad vi koristite vegeta?
Pa uglavnom u varivu, ono, u variva, ma skoro u juhe obavezno, u pečenja, ma svugdje, jer s vegetom se bolje jede.
Just a delicious kind of veggie, all-purpose seasoning that goes really with a lot. Kada jedete špek?
Svaki dan, neću reći svaki dan za gablec, tjedno dva, tri puta sa bilim lukom.
He's totally playing it down. He eats it almost every day. He's just trying to sound healthier for the camera. This is definitely a staple in any Croatian house. To have a chunk of bacon in the fridge that they just kind of cut up, have for a snack, serve to guests, put it in some other dishes. Without a big chunk of bacon like this, you can't really call yourself Croatian. There has to be at least two or three of these little coffee pots. This one is for 2 cups. This one is for 4 cups. And this one is for 6 cups. Because heaven forbid you make 2 cups of coffee in the 6 cup pot. So you have to have the right size pot in order for the coffee, I guess, to taste how it should. Every Croatian house has to have at least 2 or 3 of these džezvas, which are the pots for making Turkish coffee, which is really the most popular way to make coffee here in Croatia. I love Turkish coffee. It's the only kind of coffee I drink nowadays, but I have 1 džezva and it's electric, so definitely breaking some rules there. Another thing that most Croatian households have is this calendar here showing all the holidays and the name days. So most names have their own day of the year and you kind of celebrate that person whose name it is. There are many more holidays in Croatia than back home in Canada, so you definitely need a calendar like this to keep track of everything. Usually the churches give out these calendars and everyone has one inside of their cupboards for easy reference. Okay, so in any Croatian home, you're probably going to find some kind of lace decor around the house. And so either on the table, on a TV stand, somewhere, but you'll definitely find some kind of lace. Lace is a very, very traditional kind of handicraft here in Croatia, and it's really, really famous from the island of Pag. Most Croatians have these kind of old school thermometers. Because they just don't trust the new electric ones. They just think that they're not gonna give the right results. So they only trust the good old fashioned mercury thermometers.
Ne vjerujete baš ovaj te novi?
Pa skoro da, oni jesu brži, ali ovaj je baš pouzdan.
Okay, and here you will definitely find some rose hip tea. There you go.
Ovo je čaj od šipka. On je najbolji za... Za sad, za prehlade. Ima puno vitamina C I ono, ljekovit je. Evo, I to svi imamo.
Okay, so along with the rosehip tea, there's definitely going to be some rosehip jam in this fridge. Here it is. There you go. Definitely a staple in any Croatian's fridge. They put it on pancakes, the little crepes they make. They put it on lots of different things, but a big one is putting it on palačinke, so like kind of Croatian pancakes that are really thin. So it's really, really common to have the šipak tea and also the šipak jam. So it's really common in many Croatian households to have in their pantries a bunch of different boxes of cookies. So baka will always have a few different boxes of cookies just in case any guests come over on short notice and she hasn't prepared any cake or anything, so.
Napolitanke, we have some domačice and some extra coffee, of course, just in case. Oh, we have some more napolitanke up here.
They are the best. You cannot even buy them anymore, but every Croatian household has them.
Znači 40 godina ove deke imaju.
Opa.
To se više ne proizvodi, to se radilo u Buteksu iz Vukovara, a taj grad je, zna se kak je nastradao. I to je izvrsna kvaliteta, ja ne znam je li ima igdje I dezen, pogledaj ovo. Stvarno, da su izvrste.
They come in mainly shades of orange and brown and burgundy, but they really are just super comfy blankets, super warm. The quality is excellent. Like Baka said, these blankets are like 40 years old and they're still going strong. Don't wear down. And yeah, they're just a staple in every Croatian household.
So yeah, this is one thing which I would say like 90% of Croatian households have Croatian checkers. Jersey, shirt, hat. This jersey, I like it a lot because it's different and it's like, you can recognize that it's from 1998 World Cup when we won third place. So yeah, it's from our football player Alen Bokšić. And that generation stayed in my heart because this was the first time when we won something on any competition in football. Now we even won better. In 2018 we won second place and probably kids have jerseys of Luka Modric, even Rakitic, but this one, 22 years old, it stays in my heart.
Thank you so much for watching our video on 15 things that every Croatian has in their home. Let me know, do you have any of these things in your home? And did I forget anything? Let me know if I forgot something major. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to see even more videos just like this. I hope to see you again really, really soon.